The Sunderban forests, the largest mangrove forest in the whole world. Once upon a time, a woodcutter planned to go to the forest of Sunderban for collecting wood. Sunderban is full of wild animals, especially tigers. So an experienced person warned the woodcutter that it might be fatal if he enters the forest without being adequately armed. He must carry arms with himself in order to be safe in the forest. But the woodcutter denied. He said that there is no need of entering the forest with arms, because there are so many big trees in the forest. He told that if I use a broken branch from one of those trees, all the wild animals will run away here and there. If I see any animal approaching, I will break a branch from a tree and threaten the beast with that branch, so much so that it will not even dare to come near me. It will simply run away, seeing the branch of the tree in my hand. The woodcutter thought himself to be very prudent, but he did not have the common sense that in case a tiger came and jumped upon him suddenly, then within that time he will not be able to break a branch from any tree, and it will not be able to protect himself. And actually the same thing happened. The woodcutter entered the forest and a tiger came and easily jumped on him before he could break a branch from the tree. The tiger easily caught hold of his neck and completely eaten that woodcutter before he could realize anything. The sad news of the woodcutter's death in the hands of a jungle tiger, Royal Bengal tiger, came to his home, and the entire village was very sad. Actually, the woodcutter, being very prudent, thought that he will be able to protect himself by using any branch of a tree. But he didn't know that how powerful the tiger is. And when the tiger will jump, then he will not be able to cut any branch from a tree and save himself. Actually, friends, there is a moral behind this story. We all have senses. We all have five senses and mind. And all these senses are very powerful. The mind is very, very powerful. So this mind and all these senses are always wanting so many things of this world. Just for example, sex desire. The mind may want sex desire. The yogis try to control their sex desire by yoga practice and by doing so many austerities. But history has witnessed that even by so many austerities, even by performing so many laborious, tough austerities, great sages have not been able to control their sex desires. Just like Vishwamitra Muni, he was doing so much great penance, so much great austerity, but he could not control his sex desire when Menaka, the heavenly damsel, the heavenly lady, approached him. And being allured by sex desire, Vishwamitra Muni had sexual intercourse with Menaka, and a child was born. So our senses are actually very, very powerful. We cannot control our senses by artificial means, by suppressing them through laborious methods and physical feats. The only method of controlling these senses is by taking to the devotional service of the Supreme Lord Krishna. Just by surrendering to Krishna, just by having devotion to Krishna, one can control all his senses very easily. So one should remember Krishna, one should worship Krishna, one should chant the holy names of Krishna, Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Just following this devotional path, just following this devotional service to Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Supreme Lord Himself, one can easily get rid of all these dangerous pushings of the senses. So this is the simple method of controlling one's five senses and the mind. Just develop this loving service to Krishna. Chant His holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This is the simple method of controlling one's tiger-like senses and the mind. Hare Krishna. Thank you for listening to this story, and please apply the moral of this story in your life and you will be successful for sure. Hare Krishna.